I need a mop on this damn stage. Whiplash. I'm bending these blocks and the thing changed. Get cash forever, it's never enough, bitch. I save change. Big facts. I'm leveling up, you the same lane.
Third final video for the week. This reaction that I'm about to, this music video that I'm about to react to is Dear God by Dax. Thank you to Zuna for the request. And I'm gonna go ahead and react to 3, 2, 1.
There's a lot of questions that I have about the past. And I don't want to hear it from a human. You made it, so you're the last person that I'm ever going to ask. Tell me what's real. Tell me what's fake. Why is everything about...
He said, I want you, God, to tell me about the past. Because you're the only one that knows. And every other human may think that they know what they're talking about. And how the events went down according to a book, maybe. That was written. But... you truly know the past. You know the events that happened, when and how it happened. So instead of going through someone else, I'd rather go straight to you and ask you. And it makes sense. If a person says they know something and another person is really curious, just ask and see what they tell you.
You would debate. What's the point of love? Every time I showed it, I was broken, and it's forced me just to only want to hate. Why is it only one you but multiple religions? Why does every conversation end in a division? Why does everybody want to tell us how to live, but they won't listen to the same damn message that they give? Tell me how to feel. Tell me what's wrong.
Oh my God. He said, how come people want to display a message and then not live by it? Basically saying, why do people want to live by the sword one way and die and not die by it? Why you try to preach to someone else when you're probably not even living that way? That's just like the devil. That's just like the devil preaching positivity, but he's not doing that.
I tried to call, pick up the phone, pick up on my own. Everybody says you coming back to man. Why the hell's it taking so long? Why do I hurt? Why is there pain? Why does everything good always have to change? Why does everybody try to profit off another man's work then destroy it just for monetary gain? Tell me, are you black or are you white? I don't even really care. I just really want to know what's right. They've been saying one thing, but I've been looking in the book, and it seems like they've been lying for my whole damn life. Tell me where I'm going. Is it heaven or hell? I just hope this message greets you well. Had a dream that I was walking with the devil. Don't remember how it feels, but I swear that I remember the smell. Looked me right into my eye and told me everything I wanted could be mine if I gave up and decided to sell. But I said I'd rather die than get mine. Now I'm here. No fear, one man with a story to tell. Dear God, where were you when I needed it? When I fucked up and repeated it? When they set the bar and I exceeded it? My life is like a book that they've been judging by a cover, but have never took the time to fucking read the shit. I remember telling you my goals and my dreams, but you didn't even answer, so I guess you didn't believe in it. I remember sitting with a gun to my head trying to ask you for some help, but I guess you didn't believe it. I don't want religion, I need that spirituality. I don't want a church, I need people to call a family. I don't want to tell my sins to another sinner just because he's got a robe and you went to some academy.
God, he said, I don't need people, I need a family. No, yeah. He said, I need people to call a family. I need real ones, because right now there's a lot of... He said something about spirituality. Maybe he really... I don't know, but... He said he needs a family. He said he don't need... Let me go back. I don't want to sound stupid. Let me go back.
I remember telling you my goals and my dreams, but you didn't even answer, so I guess you didn't believe in it. I remember sitting with a gun to my head trying to ask you for some help, but I guess you didn't believe it. I don't want religion, I need that spirituality. I don't want a church, I need people to call a family. I don't want to tell my...
I don't need religion. I need spirituality. I don't need a church. I need people I call family. He feels like religion isn't going to help, but spirituality will probably be, will probably help him, will probably guide him better than religion in life anyway. Because I've always heard that religion is man-made, but dealing with spirituality is from within. So he, I think he'd rather know himself and be surrounded by people that he called, like, be surrounded by his family or people that he calls family, instead of being around people that are in church. Because people that go to church, there's some people that I'm not sure because I haven't been to church in a while, but there's people that go to church on Sunday just to be there, and then the rest of the week they're out committing sins and all this stuff. Don't know. Again, I'm not a genius at this. I just know that people make mistakes. People do some messed up stuff. I know I probably haven't done a lot of it, but I'm pretty sure in my past I've done some messed up stuff. But these are probably the same people that'll be preaching the word of God to you and righteousness when they're not even doing it. They just like any other human being, with the ability to commit a sin, to do some messed up stuff, whether they had to do it or they chose to.
Sins to another sinner just because he's got a robe and you went to some academy. I don't want to read it in the book. I want to hear it from you. Don't want to learn it in my school because they hiding the truth. Don't want to talk about it to another fucking human being. And that's the only reason that I even step in this booth. Dear God, how do I take this darkness and turn it into light? How do I believe in the concept where I speak to a man I've never seen with my own two eyes? How do I know that religion wasn't made just to separate the world and create a whole disguise just to keep us in these chains while the rich get richer and the poor pray to you and perpetuate a lie? How do I know this ain't some big joke? How can I have faith when there is no hope? How the hell does one man have $100 billion and we still have people on the street that are broke? There's a lot of things I want to talk about and get off my chest. I can't sleep because the devil won't let me rest. I used to know a fucking pastor in a church and I can still hear the screams of the kids he will fucking molest. Dear God!
Yo, when I first heard about that, I was like, what? Wait a minute, this is not making sense. I was like, how do you preach the word of God, but you're out here molesting kids? It doesn't make sense. And I think I did say that I went to church when I was younger. One, I remember stopping, but I am aware that preachers are just, that some preachers, I think there's some preachers that actually, well, I don't know, but I am aware that there is a thing where preachers hustle the people at the church with the offering to use it to go buy lavish things. And it's like, how are you hustling the people if you're supposed to be preaching the word of God and to help them get on the path of righteousness, but you're doing it for monetary gain? That means there's no real purpose for you doing it other than the money.
Supposed to fear you, but you ain't said shit. So maybe it's you who actually fears me. I don't know the answer, I just want to see it clearly. So many.
Oh yeah. Speaking of, he said, I might have to go back. It just popped in my head. It was a song called Confess by Logic. It's featuring Killer Mike. He was like, Why do people that believe in everything you've ever said, no, why do people that go against everything you've ever said always get ahead? Meaning if God is displaying the path of righteousness, why is it that the people that don't preach that or live that lifestyle, why are they getting ahead and the people that are being held back? that's where I was trying to think about. There was a certain point in this song where he mentioned it, and it didn't click right then for me to stop the video and talk about it. That's crazy. Anyway.
Lies is a thousand different theories. All I want to know is who really made religion, because I know it wasn't you, but don't nobody believe me. No more lies, no more death. Bring back King, bring back X. Please, dear God, let their soul rest. Protect who's left and watch their steps. Dear God.
Oh, yeah, I noticed something else, too. People that preach, like especially people on a public platform that preach positivity, it's like they get shunned. They get sent to the shadow realm. Like, they don't matter. I remember there was a certain time, there was a certain point in time where Wale wasn't played on the radio because he was preaching positivity. Like, his songs gave a positive vibe instead of a negative one. And I'll be honest with you, I haven't heard anything from NF since, maybe he dropped an album this year, maybe he's coming out next year with an album, but I haven't heard anything from NF since the Clouds mixtape. Makes me wonder if he's been sent, if he's been off the scenes because maybe enough of his music is not being played on the radio, or I don't know. But yeah, it seems like if you try to preach positivity or do something on a public platform, then you'll get shunned or you'll get killed. It's crazy. It's insane to me.
To ask you again, I just hope that you know that I'm still a believer, so I'll end this all by saying amen. Stacks.
My movie opens.
All right, that was Dear God by Dax. Thank you again to Zuna for all three requests for this week. I'm going to now read out the songs that I'm going to react to next week. And those are as follows. The first one that I'm going to react to next week is Gotham by Dax. The second one is Propaganda by Dax. And the final one is Joe Biden Crack by Nick Natoli. And with that said, this has been Dante Brown. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. Enjoy your day. I'll do the same. And I am out.
Look at my life, look at everything I got, it's nice. It's crazy how God blessed me twice. I still can't feel anything but ice. Damn, I'm a demon by heart. That was my part. From